We have coconut, we have coffee, we have banana, we have pineapple back up over there. We have a Rollinia deliciosa here. We have Cassia grandis there and Cassia grandis here, which are both leguminous tree species, so they fix nitrogen out of the soil, into the soil through root nodulation. We have another leguminous tree. This is an Erythrina pepper. This area here that we're in was, in the terminal classic period, a densely populated city. There were a lot of people here. So if we had 80 house mounds on this land, average Maya household size is about 8 people. So that's 640 people. So we had 640 people on this land that left trace that we can see. They were prosperous, middle class people that could leave something that somebody like me would be able to recognize. There is no way that they could have done this with a corn-based economy. If you step back and look at the larger picture, it's pretty productive. Like I said, we have about 500 species that we use. We have marketable crops, we have medicinal crops, we have leguminous tree crops that fix nitrogen, we have timber species. We have a lot of food that we eat coming off the farm. Yeah.
Most farmers, if you go into the communities, are stuck to that traditional farming system of slash and burn and doing just a two-crop cycle, which is corn and beans, because that is what they mostly consume in these communities. So that has been one of the main challenges that we have had in trying to get them to switch from the slash and burn into a slash and mold system, and also to switch from just planting corn and beans to diversifying your farm.
Many people like to do slash and burn, and at the end of the day, slash and burn is not something which is good for the environment. Many of the farmers also cut down trees for firewood. So at the end, we are destroying the forest. How can we put that back? Because most of our people may not know the end effect of it. So we have to go back and teach our people to continue what they used to do. The Mayans are the oldest folks in this part of the world. And their system of farming, you could know that apart from setting fire, they used to mix everything, and they do it. They knew that mixing things was good for the soil, but they never wrote it anywhere. But yet they used to practice it.
Where I'm working, every time I'm opening my tray, pinning my banana, I'm studying where it need help, so I just move towards that work.
I'm just a tool, and I see to it that they're happy, clean, healthy, and grow naturally. I don't really do anything. I just caretaker. Yeah, that's why most of the time in this world here, this life here I have, I never say I own this land here. I can only be a caretaker. We are all caretaker too.
So if I was an industrial farmer, particularly a citrus farmer, I would see leafcutter ants as a problem. Leafcutter ants are actually a symptom of other problems. They're an indicator that your system is out of balance, your soil is damaged. You only see leafcutter ants in the wake of a catastrophe. 5,000 acres of citrus, leafcutter ants are going to come in there. problem is the solution. So this is a very good example of this. The problem was, again, back it up, this was citrus in here when I bought the land. The solution was the leaf cutter ants, and they're repairing it. They've been repairing it for quite some time. The solution to the problem of the leaf cutter ants is the solution to another problem, which is, what do I feed my chickens? The chickens will take this problem, convert it to resources. They'll convert it to meat, they'll convert it to eggs, to feathers, and to manure. Those are all products. And the services the chickens are providing is pest control, they're eating that, and then the manuring.
Those are the Maya Mountain. So this is a Maya Mountain. Ah, this is Maya Mountain. So every hilltop is where my ancestors were living. And farming is another thing. I believe that's a very special gift God give us. The main thing for human being is learn to plant your food and get to know where the food comes from and what is food. Mm-hmm. Cook your food, plant your food, and give thanks and praise.